Let's look at the solution to our multi-predictor quiz, where we have a program for which the 2-bit predictor works for many instructions, P-share covers some additional instructions, and G-share covers the rest that P-share doesn't cover, but all of them can correctly predict the same branches that the 2-bit predictor can. So because the 2-bit predictor covers the most branches and it's the cheapest predictor, what we want to do is use the 2-bit predictor for most of the branches. So the correct answer here is E, hierarchical predictor, that chooses between a 2-bit predictor and a predictor that combines the P-share and G-share. So what this first part does is it basically makes most of the branches just go to the 2-bit predictor so that the space in the more expensive predictor here will be reserved for only the branches that actually need to go there because the 2-bit predictor is not predicting them correctly. Because P-share and G-share have different strengths and neither of them is clearly superior to the other, we are not going to combine them using a hierarchical predictor. We are going to combine them using a tournament predictor that will choose between P-share and G-share. So the correct answer is that the overall predictor is a hierarchical predictor that chooses between a 2-bit predictor and a tournament predictor, which itself chooses between P-share and G-share, or the other way around.